to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, well, we'll call Dan Kroll to the front. Dan Kroll. All right, for Mr. Kroll and for everybody else too, you have 10 minutes to make your opening statement. You were given some questions also. Then we will have 8 minutes for follow-up questions, and then you'll have a 2-minute pitch to tell us why.
You got it.
Thank you. You may begin.
First of all, I want to thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to discuss my application. I don't envy your task. No matter what decision you make, there's going to be a large percentage of the electorate that doesn't feel as though their voice was heard. There'll be those who voted for a mayor who's no longer in office. There may be those who feel that installing someone who's already run and lost the popular vote, that that's unfair. There's also the situation and of equal concern that someone who was never on the ballot might be installed as mayor. Admittedly, I fall into that category. When I first told people that I was thinking of applying for mayor, I got one of three responses. The first was, oh my God, he'd be a great mayor, which was really nice to hear. The second was, why would you want to be mayor? And the third was somewhat surprising to me, and it was, I thought council had pretty much already decided who they wanted as the next mayor. I don't take the decision to apply for mayor lightly. I gave it a lot of thought. In fact, I was here the final day. I gave the entire period of time to decide if this is something that I really thought that I should be doing. My idea of spontaneity is ordering a cheese dog instead of a plain hot dog at Gacko's. That's just sort of the way that I am. I'm probably the most measured person that I know, and it's going to be hard to give you a look into all of what I think I can do for the city in 10 minutes, but I'm going to do the best that I possibly can. So here's some bullet points why I feel I'm qualified to serve as mayor. I was born and raised in Allentown. I am the proud product of the Allentown School District. I'm a registered Democrat. I haven't recently made any changes to my party affiliation. I did not apply for mayor as a stepping stone. I'm not looking to serve, to use as a stepping stone to a greater public office. My main interest is serving the city as mayor. I don't think there's ever been a time when it's been so important to seriously consider someone for the position of mayor who's not part of the establishment. For nearly 25 years now, I've owned and operated a highly successful internet business. I've weathered the dot-com bust, the Great Recession, and the changing habits that we're all going through as consumers. I've been able to do this by exercising fiscal responsibility, by surrounding myself with the best people that I can possibly find in all of their respective areas. And I've also found that I refuse to accept anything less than success. I try as hard as I can to accomplish whatever it is that I set out to do and find a way to make that happen. Outside of that, I've also served on the executive board both as treasurer and secretary of a 22-acre condominium development in Center City. I understand operating budgets, and I understand challenging the balances and the needs of the community as a whole versus those of individuals. Admittedly, that was on a much larger, or a much smaller scale than what we here in Allentown, but it's still an experience that I don't think should be discounted. This is probably going to come as a surprise to anyone who knows me. I may ask this to be stricken from the record, including to my fiance who's in the back of the room. I don't know everything. I don't consider that to be a flaw or a liability. In fact, I think anybody who comes before you and says that they have all of the answers to all the problems is setting themselves up for failure. Since there will undoubtedly be a learning curve for anyone who you pick as mayor, including myself, I'm willing to give my salary for the first 30 to 45 days back to the city. I feel that that is the appropriate time that it would take me to get a good grasp on what the office of mayor should be doing. If for some reason that's not possible, I would be more than happy to donate that money to establish a scholarship for high school students or to come up with any other organization to give it to they would that we mutually agree upon. In my application, I laid out four different areas that I think are most important to address if I was elected as mayor. The most important thing for me is to regain the trust of the residents of the city and those who work for the city. We've lost a great deal of talent over the last few years. It's important to find out why. If we don't find out why, we're going to be in the same position we are now. Within the first 2 months, I want to hold town hall meetings in every corner of the city as possible. I want to get to know what the needs are of the community, and I want them to know that I'm there to serve them. I'm not looking to be mayor for myself. I'd also want to sit down with the various departments of the city, not just the heads, but all of the employees of all the departments, to find out what's working and what's not. It's important to meet with everyone, because it's critical that they feel that they're part of a team. It's also vitally important to return Allentown governments to something that's more collaborative and less combative. All someone has to do is pick up the Connect the Dots case study that you included in the questionnaire. This has created a sense of politics as usual. I really hate using that term, but it's a term that when you use it, everybody knows exactly what it means. There's a fear among the general public that elected officials really aren't looking out for those who elected them. I want to restore a sense of cooperation between the city council and the office of the mayor. I don't expect that we would agree on everything, and I think that's all right. I think the most important thing is for there to be a mutual respect. The Code of Ethics rightfully took up probably the large portion of the questionnaire on the agenda. And it's not to gloss over it, but simply put, I have no conflicts of interest that would prevent me from performing the duties of mayor. If anything were to arise that even seemed like it could be a conflict, I would remove myself from the situation immediately, though I don't foresee that happening. There are a lot of similarities between what's going on in Allentown now and what happened in Philadelphia when I moved there in the 1990s. There's a visibly changing downtown, and there's a sense for people who don't live in downtown, whether it be residents or businesses, what about us? I think it's important for residents on the east side or the south side to feel the same sense of importance, to feel that same feeling of security as those who are downtown. Making sure that there's leadership in the police department is key to making those changes and to improving morale. It's also vital that the fire department has all of the equipment that they need to keep and protect the residents of the city. The men and women of the police and fire departments put their lives on the line for us every single day, and they need to know that we have their backs. Of course, all of this costs money. It's already a foregone conclusion among most people that a tax hike is coming, and there's probably going to be more of a sticker shock than there would have been normally, because for the last decade or so, there have been no tax hikes through some artificial shifting of funds. Last night, there was an assertion by one of the other candidates that the city budget deficit could be as much as $8 million. We recently learned that the school district is also $28 million in the red. We're told that they didn't see it coming. You never hear politicians say this, but since I'm not a politician, I have no problem saying it. I don't want to pay higher taxes. My grandmother, who still lives in the city, she's on the south side, she has a hard enough time paying her property taxes now. As a business owner, I've operated on the principle that things don't get done unless you have the money to get them done. Before I would consider any tax hike, I would go through every single line of the budget, analyze it to make sure that there's no money being wasted on things like a bungled pool refurbishment. In addition to being aggressive in applying for grants, I think it's also important that we explore other options that may not have been done before, things that may be viewed as outside of the box, maybe even controversial. It would include corporate sponsorships of potentially things like parks and advertising. I'm not somebody who needs the credit or the glory for coming up with an idea. If I'm in the process of having discussions with city workers or city residents, if an idea comes up that's a blockbuster idea and it gets implemented, I'm with the person who came up with the idea to get the credit. There were also some interesting ideas presented last night from other candidates. So far, everyone who's spoken has said that they have the best interests of Allentown at heart. And I would hope that if for some reason, if council does select me, I would hope that all the other applicants would hold to what they said when they gave their speeches, that they had the interests of the city at heart, and that they would continue to work with the city to possibly implement some of those ideas. I can say tonight that if I'm not selected, I will be willing to assist the mayor, city council, and anyone else in any way that I can. I know, based on my application, you have plenty of questions, and I look forward to answering them.
Thank you, sir. We will open it up to council. And I don't remember which side I started on last night, which side I ended on. Okay, so we'll start on this side tonight. Mr. Reedy, Mr. Hendricks, any questions? Ms. Asa.
Can you come back, because I'm writing something here. I have a question, but you'll certainly come back. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Hendricks.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Kroll, do you have any experience in dealing with municipal government?
As working with the executive board of the condominium and development, I did do lots of liaison work between the community and the city, whether it be for city planners or coming up with architectural improvements with the historic coalition. In terms of actually serving on city government, I do not.
Okay, and was that in the city of Philadelphia?
It was.
Speaking of?
Yes.
And you lived in there at one time?
I did. I lived there from the late 1900s until 2015.
Okay. And other than that, you were in no boards or commissions or anything like that? Any experience with that?
Volunteer boards, yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good evening. Thank you for applying. Could you touch a little bit on crime and the police department and how you would handle situations in the city, and if you thought you would go outside the city for a new chief, or you would pick one from within our community?
Oh, absolutely. I'm a victim of crime. When I moved to Philadelphia when I was in college, planning to be a doctor, I was attacked in the subway system in Philadelphia, and it forever changed my life. It actually sent me on the trajectory that I am today. So it's one of those situations where it's the worst thing to happen to me, but at the same time, I wouldn't be where I am without it. That's given me a great appreciation for those who serve in the police department. I think that right now we're in a situation that, again, we've lost leadership, and we don't necessarily know why. I think it's important, A, to address that. In the short term, I think we should look within and look to see who's been here, who's served, who's made Allentown their home, who wants to continue to make Allentown their home, and consider them for leading the department. I also do think that it would be due diligence to extend the search nationwide. We want to get the best candidate for the position. But again, at the same time, I do think that there needs to be a little bit of weight applied to the folks who've been here, who know that Allentown is their home and aren't looking to use this as a position to try to go somewhere else.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good evening, Mr. Crow.
Good evening.
Okay. Thank you for coming and for applying, for having an interest in the city, and for having an interest in helping council and the city in general. Now, you talked about not raising taxes. You said that you...
I said I don't want to pay more taxes.
Yes. I don't want to pay more taxes.
Absolutely.
But, and you also don't want to increase any fees. You want to look into something else before doing that. And as you know, some of the grants that the city gets, they're allocated for certain issues.
Absolutely.
You don't just get grants to have money and spend it whatever they are, whatever you want to, as you say. And we've been doing that. What do you think you can bring differently to, what are you looking for that you bring differently than what we already have done?
I would actually like to seize upon the experiences that I've had. I've made my living through advertising, through marketing, in addition to, it's a long, complicated story with the internet, but the way that I've made my living is through advertising, through corporate sponsorships. While I don't necessarily think that that is the solution to everything, I certainly think that it could be a way to get an additional a revenue stream, whether it be that we bring in someone like Lehigh Valley Health Network to sponsor the park system, since parks are, and being able to enjoy the parks are great for self-being, for relaxation, for health. Get a revenue stream from them to be able to have a dedicated source to pay for something like that, while it then frees up money that we may have already been using for that, sort of allocated elsewhere. It's not the same general shell game that I had been discussing about why taxes haven't been raised. And just to be clear, I'm also not saying that I would not raise taxes. That anyone who says that, I don't think that they're being honest. I'm saying I don't want to. I know the impact. I was raised by a single mom. As I said, my grandmother still lives here, and she has difficulty paying her taxes. I hear it from a lot of neighbors that they're considering moving out of the city because taxes are so high. I come from Philadelphia, where they're actually higher, but everything is relative. And I think that in order to keep people here, they need to know that we're exhausting every single possibility, that we're not taking the money for granted, that if we ask them for more money by raising taxes, we have to be able to explain where that money is going, and that have to be some sort of nebulous location. There needs to be something tangible. If they see more fire trucks on the street, that's something they can say, I don't like having to write out this bigger check. But at least it's something that they can see. It's something that's beneficial rather than sort of filling in for government waste or for expenses that we should have had to incur based on previous administrations.
You, by the way, you know that our parks are being usually covered by the trust fund, the transfer trust fund, right?
Yes.
Okay. That's all. Thank you.
Yes.
Anybody?
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Mr. Kroll, for being here tonight, for applying, and for taking an interest. In regards to economic development, can you just lay out some ideas as to what you think might be a better strategy than what we've implemented in the past to develop neighborhoods outside of the neighborhood improvement zone?
I think the challenge in that is that it's great to be able to say, look at our downtown. As I said, it's the same thing that happened in Philadelphia, where there was so much of a focus being in Center City that a lot of the other areas were sort of disregarded. Some of the solutions, some of the things that have been put forward there that I would sort of use the experience from living in Philadelphia to try to apply it here, would be to have other incentives in other communities to hold, I know one of the big issues is blight, to hold owners of those properties responsible, get them taken care of. There were some extreme measures that were taken in Philadelphia to get blight under control. But for business, I mean, I don't think, we only have a bit of time left, I don't think that those that are outside of the downtown, out of the neighborhood improvement zone, I don't think that they should be handicapped by not being able to have the same benefits that are here. Finding out exactly what that would be meeting with the with finance board, with different organizations within in the city to try to find the best way to handle that. I don't know if there's a magic it's going to be. I don't know if there's a magic way to resolve it in the course of 8 minutes.
All right, Mr. Kroll, thank you also. We don't always get to ask all the questions that we want, but now you have 2 minutes to tell us why you should be the mayor of Allen.
I will admit that at first glance, I am probably the most unique applicant to apply for mayor, maybe in the history of the city. And sure, there may be questions about how can the guy that writes about evil twins run the third largest city in Pennsylvania. I would take a look at where I've come from and to look at where I am now. I was raised by a single mom here in Allentown, and I understand the sacrifices that families sometimes have to make. I moved away from Allentown, but I returned here because this is the place that always felt like home to me. This is the place where I want to start my family. I live in perhaps the most storied home in the city. I understand the importance of embracing the future, but not forgetting the past. I usually have no trouble finding words to express myself, but there's a quote from former President Obama that I feel really applies to the situation. Hope is not blind optimism. It's not ignoring the enormity of the task ahead or the roadblocks that stand in our path. It's not sitting on the sidelines and shirking from a fight. Hope is the thing inside us that insists, despite all evidence to the contrary, that something better awaits for us if we have the courage to reach for it and to work for it and to fight for it. I've spent my entire life fighting for everything that I have. And I know that there are far too many people in this city who feel that they have no one fighting for them. Selecting me to serve as the mayor is a chance to change that. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.